Well, the search for the terrorists behind last week's attacks in Paris has now led investigators across the Belgian border into Brussels, to the district of Molenbeek. Now, this is an area some are calling the terror capital of Europe. The alleged ringleader of the Paris attacks reportedly lived in this neighborhood, and Fox News foreign affairs correspondent Benjamin Hall traveled there to get the story.
Megan, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. These are the shocking words we heard spoken today openly on the streets of Brussels as some residents sought to justify the attacks in Paris over the weekend, also laying bare the radicalization problem at the heart of Europe. Today I spoke to young Muslim men in the now infamous district of Molenbeek, from where both the mastermind and some of the Paris attackers came from. It was shocking to hear them condone the massacre and speak openly about what they accepted was fair retaliation for bombings in Syria and Iraq. One of the attackers, Saleh Abdeslam, is now on the run here, thought to be nearby, armed and dangerous. Police continue to search for him here in the Belgian capital, following dramatic raids yesterday as police abseiled into buildings. Meanwhile, today, the mayor of this embattled district spoke, saying that they had long been aware of the problems here, but that they were unable to keep watch because they simply didn't have enough police. And now they need help from the government. Perhaps too little, too late. Belgium has the highest percentage per capita of jihadis in Europe who have gone to Syria and Iraq, up to 500. Most worryingly, 130 have come back. The district is also where weapons for many of these attacks have been sourced. Not just Kalashnikovs and grenades, but explosives and even rocket launchers are available here. The Paris mastermind, Abdul Hamid Abaoud, comes from here and planned 4 deadly attacks this year. It must be said that the majority of people here condemn the attacks, but there is certainly a dark undercurrent of radicalization in this country, as through much of Europe, and that the authorities seem powerless to stop it. Megan?
Benjamin Hall, thank you. For more on this, we turn to Josh Katz, a former CIA operations officer and a former counterterrorism advisor to the House Committee on Homeland Security. Josh, thank you very much for being here. And so you heard that a dark undercurrent of radicalization throughout Europe, which doesn't come as a huge surprise, but boy, we've seen it in operation in the past week.
Yeah, absolutely, Megan. Thank you for having me. This is, I actually think a lot of people, a lot of your viewers are going to be absolutely shocked to learn that just 5 miles from NATO headquarters is this area where a radicalization is happening. It's been happening now for almost a generation. There are weapons that are available, high caliber weapons. So this is a area that where we're seeing it's like network central for radicalization and for jihadi operations throughout Europe.
How? I mean, Belgium just allows this to go on?
Well, you know, it's a combination of a lot of things, mostly by very, very poor government oversight, lack of police, lack of intelligence. There are a lot of laws here. And actually, really interestingly, up until 2006, Brussels was, and Belgium as a whole, really had very lax gun control laws. And so there is basically a perfect storm here of a lot of different factors that have made this just a hotbed for radicalization.
Okay, so what people are very worried about is, you know, we're pretty open doors when it comes to our friends over in Europe coming into the United States. And the other question is, we've been hearing all night about the number, the growing number. Like every night we hear a different and larger number of ISIS-related individuals believed to be in the United States, open cases they have. So the question is whether that kind of radicalization activity, centralized and festering, is happening here and how easily the folks from Brussels can come on into the United States.
Megan, it's very, very easy. Actually, there is no visa requirement, so they can take their EU passport, get on a plane, and come to America. We've actually seen known terrorists do that and take that route. So it's absolutely happened. And the radicalization is absolutely going on inside the United States. And what I would say to your viewers is that the numbers are absolutely not known. I believe that the numbers are much higher than anybody's really talking about. But the bottom line here is nobody knows.
Why hasn't it happened here then? You know, this ISIS, this kind of attack on the soft targets where they just unleash hell on civilians, and of course I'm aware of 9/11, but I'm talking about ISIS and here.
Right. Right, absolutely. And, you know, we should not, we shouldn't be under any false pretense that it's not coming. It is coming. They are trying. They're trying in a lot of different ways. We have been very fortunate to this point. I think actually we've been lucky, but it's coming. And now we, as the population, we're on the front lines here, Megan. There's no other way to say it. We're on the front line.
Wow. Josh, thank you.
Thank you.